Alright guys, quick Throwback Thursday video, and I'm showing you today a model that it's not very popular, not a lot of people know about, but very interesting and definitely something I really loved back in the day when they came out. This model, as you can already guess, is Shaq, and it's called Shaq Trainer in this beautiful black and white colorway. This model was kind of created, actually let me start from the beginning. They created two models called Shaq Trainer. The very first one is even less popular than this one, less well known, different outsole, a little bit of a different upper. I have pictures of it, but probably I'm going to upload sometime in the future to show it to you guys. But it was definitely a little bit different. Then they came out with this one, which is kind of a version 2 of Shaq Trainer. And Shaq actually played with these, of course, in his own version. His shoes always been kind of a taller with the Instapump nozzle right on the side, so he can, you know, pump his Achilles pump chamber for extra support. But these are absolutely beautiful. I like the black and white color combination. There was two colorways created back in the day. It was this one, black and white, and there was another one that was almost entirely white. Only the straps were kind of a black or navy, and actually the outsole was darker, black or navy. I'm not entirely sure. I think it was black maybe. And of course the vector was white there, kind of a reverse. But I really like this colorway better, even when Shaq actually wore them back in the day. And let me talk to you about the shoe. So they came out kind of right the same time when he had the Shaq 4, a little bit later, and right before he received his Shaq Gnosis. And it was interesting design. They were the first ones he had that featured both Hexalite on the forefoot and the heel. As you can see, Ultra Hexalite on the heel. Bunch bigger cells, very responsive when you put them on your feet. Forefoot, normal Hexalite, again, old style. These are the original pairs. I don't think Reebok are planning to bring them anytime soon as a retro. It would have been very nice though, but it is what it is. And as you can see, Shaq Dunkman logo with the 32 right here on a arch. And if you can see, the arch is kind of indented, sort of way more than normal. Seems like it could have had a graphite engineered at the beginning. The midsole has slight yellowing. It's not crumbling at all. Actually, I'm pushing pretty hard. It's still soft. Not bad at all. But the bad part about this is the upper. This white portion of the upper is synthetic leather, and the synthetic leather does not hold its time very well, like the original full gray leather. Sorry, yeah, I apologize for that. So this one is actually better conditioned than the other one, and I'm gonna show you what I'm talking about. Slightly yellowing all around, but I said that before, not a big deal. If that was a full grain leather, they would have held up pretty well. Those are the tags that came out with it back in the day. This is the last Reebok Shaq logo before they, you know, stopped making them at all. And of course the Reebok technology explanation. This is the later kind of a mid-90s tag that showed quick explanation of Instapump, Hexalite, and the graphite technology. You have Shaq Dunkman logo on the ton, which is actually not a ton. It is one full inner booty, similar to Shaq 3 and Shaq 4. So the whole inner is this neoprene, very breathable material, as you can see here throughout the lacing system as mesh. Lacing system, speaking of which, was very interesting. It was not your generic laces. It was more of a, let me see how to explain it. I'm sure they had a technical name for that, but it's kind of eluding me right now. This underlay that goes above the inner booty and kind of loops through the holes of the upper to create kind of a strap. So when you lace those rope laces, they pull on those bigger straps and kind of provide extra support and tightness around your foot, which they extend all the way here for a very nice heel lock. By the way, this last one goes around your heel, so when you pull to lace, this ties up really well around your heel, Achilles area, and provides super, super nice lockdown. Very big and kind of an oversized full tab on the back right here. Shaq Dunkman logo on the heel again. Inside there's nothing. I don't know if you can notice, but the upper, the black portion, has this texture nubuck. Reebok used to use texture nubuck a lot on all of their models, and it's amazing. I wish they can bring that to all the retro models they're bringing in. And another thing is there's no branding, vector branding, pretty much anywhere on the upper other than on the midsole right here. This is the only vector, or just Reebok on the ton, and of course Reebok on the outsole. Great model, not very popular, had a kind of a short life, similar to the Shaq 2, very short life, but nevertheless, I consider it as a very nice looking and very dope shoe. I wish Reebok will bring it back eventually sometime. And this is the other one. Let me get closer, see if you can guys see that, maybe the outside. This is the upper. What I'm talking about, the synthetic leather, kind of maybe crumbles. I would say it crumbles, but first it's cracking, and then over time, if you rub it, it will just start peeling. This is the coating this synthetic leather has on top of it. I'm sure when they were new, you know, they're perfectly fine. The Kamikaze one, and you know, other many shoes came with synthetic leathers. Combination with nubuck, which was working fine, but if you you know, keep them for such a long time, these are 20 years old and not in the best perfect condition, eventually this will happen and they will crumble. But yeah, otherwise not a bad condition at all. I mean, I'm very surprised. I've seen a lot of those. Their midsoles are cracked and crumbled and all that, but these midsoles held up pretty well. Very soft and responsive. Very slight yellowing. Hexalite looks fine. And you can see these feature the Ultra Hexalite, that it's top-loaded. Same here with the forefoot Hexalite. So the Hexalite patch kind of lies right underneath the insole. And it's very very comfortable when you put them on your feet. Feels definitely much more responsive than the normal bottom loaded. It was the initial creation of the Hexalite. Let me pull the insole and show it to you. Actually, the insole is very nice. This is the performance insole from the old days. You can see the perforation on the forefoot. Very thick polyurethane insole with a sort of a mimicking of the Hexalite out there. And this patch over the arch is very thick. Look how thick that is, and very soft. Provides better support for your foot for sure. Unfortunately, they don't make these kind of insoles anymore. At least not right off the back, unless you go out of your way and buy something specifically created for better fit. But I really hope someday, maybe, you know, who knows, I'm kind of losing my faith in Reebok and their creations lately and the retros they're bringing, but it is what it is. You know, I don't want to rant about it. I still love the history and love all the models they have, but it is what it is. This is the tag. See if I can show it to you real quick. That's how they, the old style tags, that's how they were. And yeah, I mean, let me know. I think it's an awesome model. I think it's definitely having some amazing history behind it. I still remember watching Shaq playing in those shoes versus the Chicago back in the day, and Michael Jordan was wearing actually the 11s, and Shaq was wearing these Shaq Trainers. It was something. It was definitely a shoe that attracted attention. It was different. A lot of us kids were wondering what kind of model is that, since we knew at that time that Shaq was rocking the Force. But yeah, that was the shoe he had on his feet. It was definitely a little bit different. Yep, and that's pretty much it, guys. Thank you very much for all your support. Unfortunately, you probably noticed I don't have a box for these, but you know, it is what it is. They're a good collective collection item for me. I won't consider them wearable. I'll just keep them in my collection and you know, part of my Reebok history. Thank you, and stay tuned to CollectiveKicks.com for more sneaker news, reviews, and history articles. And until next time, guys, you have a wonderful day.